What's going on, guys? It's your boy Swami539. Today we have the Earforce Recon 60P. Just recently picked these up at GameStop. They do have a newer color. This part is still blue, but the white accents are black. Unfortunately, that was a little bit more expensive when this one was on clearance. But they're the same headset. I also got Hitman at the time with the steelbook, so if you guys want to see an unboxing of that, I'll do that. But let's just go a quick overview over this before we get into the unboxing. As you can see, it's got the USB receiver. It has the USB receiver, it has a 3.5mm jack and RCA. So you can use this with a PS4. I believe you can use the USB part with the PS4 also. Or you could use the 3.5mm jack. You can use it with PS3, anything with RCA, or again, anything with USB, Xbox One, PC, Mac, any mobile device with a 3.5 audio jack. So this is just kind of like basically a universal headset. And it is marketed towards PS3 and PS4, but if you do look at the back of the box, you know, it does work with basically everything. Whether it's through USB, whether it's through RCA, maybe directly through TV or something, or through the back ports, or through your USB. And so we're going to get into this headset. That's just a brief overview of it. This also does have an extendable boom mic. I know Turtle Beach, you can buy some parts and all that if parts do go bad. So hopefully you should be able to get some parts for it if it does go bad. It's a very lightweight headset. It's got the an inline volume control and mic mute. So if you want to control it from the headset, that's good. It's always a nice convenience. And you do have some 40mm speakers. I wish they would have been 50, but 40 is still good. Again, this is only like a 40. This is on here, it says 40. Right now they're charging 50 unless you buy it from Turtle Beach website. I got these at GameStop, but for a $40 headset, I mean, it looks pretty good, especially if you get the back, the black one. So let's just unbox this. I actually thought I'd need a knife, and so I found like a little blade thing here, but I can just peel these off, maybe except this one. Oh, no. But this is an all-around headset, basically. You know, and for 40 bucks, I mean, it's kind of hard to find, you know, headsets like that, especially when you have a brand name like Turtle Beach. So the fact we were able to find this, I find that pretty cool. I'm trying to open this one without breaking the box. There we go. And again, this one was on clearance, but they do have their newer color is in with a black accent versus where the white is. But it's the exact same headset, exact same model. So don't think it's like a special edition or maybe there's you know, like something better about it. It's the exact same model. So now that we have those off, let's move these to the side. And let's unbox this. Right, I'll flip this over. Actually, no, I can keep it like this. Alright, so they give us some bubble wrapping, which looks like some of the wires. So here we have the RCA. In here, this is actually something a little heavier. This is the USB in here. I don't know if you can see that. We'll open those up. And then in here, you have boom mic, very important. And again, this is something you should be able to buy from Turtle Beach on their website if this were to break. And just looking at it, this looks like, I don't know if it's a 3.5 or a 2.5. It does look like a 3.5 mic. Let's zoom in on that. Looks like a 3.5 to me, but I could be wrong. But now the most important part is the headset. So let's pull this out. And there's nothing else in the box except some of this little silica gel stuff. This is the headset here. Very basic kind of design. And it actually is feeling the ear cushions there. Quite nice. They're kind of, I don't know if they are leather, and that's actually that's something I'm very surprised about. the fact that for $30 to $40, I was able to find that. You have your user manual here, and everybody knows. Throw that. And, I mean, just feeling it, it looks extremely comfy. I mean, I'm feeling the top here. This is kind of a thin layer of padding on the top there. I wish there would have been more. But it feels quite comfy. I mean, the ear cushions themselves feel very comfy. It feels very, you know, lightweight. And here you can see we can turn them and we can move them flat. So that's good if you like want to take them somewhere, or maybe, you know, if you want to use these as regular headsets for music, or if you're maybe a DJ, and, you know, you can, it's good for convenience and portability, or however your preferred listening style may be. And here also kind of an unusual design. We have two small wires going through the drivers. Usually, you know, with the headsets, they usually, through the headband or something, they'll put the wire going from one to the other. That's kind of something I just found a little bit unusual, but it's not like that affects the performance or the value of it. So we can move this away, as we have another zip tie. But these, you know, just looking at it, these look like a very good and a very solid pair of headset for the price that I paid. And just looking at it, the cord is decently long. I mean, it's pretty good. It's really all you need for the cord. I don't know if you can see it. I'm kind of retarded now that I'm looking at it. I'm doing this on a black table and the cord is black. Don't I look retarded there? As you can see here, this is a 3.5 jack. Here we have the inline mic, or not the inline mic. I'm sorry, the inline mic controls with the mute and the volume turner. So this is just like a typical standard USB headset. On some of the Turtle Beaches, though, specifically a pair that I owned, the controls actually used to be. You would plug this in, this would be an amplifier, you'd plug it in, the 3.5 in, and then you could use it through USB, or you could use it without the controls. This one, looking at it, I like it because whether or not you're using the USB part of it, you still have the controls, especially if you're going to use this on a console, so I do like that feature of it. And again, if you're going to use this with a USB, your cord length will greatly increase. I wouldn't say greatly, but I don't even think greatly is a word, but it's a word now. So now let's open up the rest of the cables and we'll put the boom mic on there. And as we can see, the USB is a good size. It's a good size length. Let's take the zip tie off. And we'll leave the headset in the thing there. Yeah, looking at this headset, looking at this cord, it's a solid length cord. And you know, here it's very simple. USB one end, other end. That's where you're gonna plug your 3.5 in. So if you want to use it through USB, that's your choice. Get this out of the way, so this kind of just looks a little bit neater. We'll just put this there. Here we're gonna have the RCA cable, so if you want to put it maybe through TV, something directly like that, you can do that. Or maybe if you have it on the computer on the back of your sound card, you have that option. And then you're still able to plug other things into them. So, you know, again, if you're using the computer option, maybe your USBs are full, and maybe your 3.5 jack is full of just maybe other peripherals. You do have the option where you can use it through your sound card. So that's a good thing. Especially since these are 40 millimeter drivers, these would be pretty solid for playing game and chat audio. So you shouldn't really have any worries in that department, whether if maybe you have a surround sound in there and you're worrying, if I disconnect my surround sound, I won't be able to hear the game as well. You should be okay. And here we have the Turtle Beach. We have the mic for it, the boom mic, which is, as we can see, it's bendable. It's quite solid, actually. You can adjust it to wherever your listening position is. So we're just gonna plug this in there. Should be in. Hang on a second. All right, so when you plug it in, I don't know if the camera will pick this up, but there is a little kind of a little groove there. So when you plug it in, and I don't know if you can see it in there, but you kind of have to actually line it up. So that's actually not bad, because a lot of times, sometimes if you hit the mic, they'll actually turn, and that will cause this to go bad. So I actually kind of like that feature that it won't move. It's quite sturdy. All right, there we go. Yeah, so you'll see it. You'll feel it plug in. Just looking at it, you'll know it's in, because when I put it in the first time, it was very easy to pull it out. This time, it's in there solid, and you can't even twist it, so I actually kind of like that feature. So just looking at this headset, it's, the boom mic I like, it's a good length, it's adjustable for any angle. So that's good. I also like the way when they make it this very thin material, sometimes they don't always, angle properly, depending on how thick that material is, so I really like that. This is just for like a $40 headset. This is very, very lightweight. It's very good quality, I have to say. The leather is nice. You get all your accessories that you need. You can use it for through 3.5, you can use it through a USB, you can use it through RCA, you can use it on console, any device really. And to find it with all these accessories and that kind of compatibility, it's very hard. I'm actually just putting this on right now, and it feels actually quite nice, although I do need to adjust it. And I believe looking at it here, you just adjust it through here, or no, you adjust it through here. Alright. Let's go with 3. Okay. Yep. So now that I'm putting this on, I have this on now, and it's actually, I do have to say, it's very comfy. It's not noise canceling, but when you put it on, it kind of does give you that feel as if it were noise canceling. And unlike the Tritons that I used to have, these are over the ear, which is quite nice. And I mean, again, even though for their $40, they may not be like the high quality leather, but they're nice. I mean, it's breathable. It's cool, which is something, that's always important. You never really want want it to heat up because it gets uncomfortable. I mean, just, putting it on for a few seconds, I'm able to adjust the mic, whether I have to bend it up a little bit and then move it. That's all good. And so just putting this on, I mean, it feels very comfy. And the fact that we can pick, Turtle Beach mics are always usually really good at picking up audio. And actually, when you kind of put it on, if you're kind of look at yourself, it's kind of like, I don't know if I would say like an aviator headset, but it just kind of, you kind of have that feeling. Maybe that's just because of the big mic or the big cover. I forget what that term is called. Cheap production didn't help me there. But, I mean, for the price I got it, $40. You can get it on sale for that price at turtlebeach.com. GameStop and Best Buy will have it. I got this at GameStop, so most likely your GameStop will have it. Just for that price, it looks like a pretty solid headset. And if you have a coupon, that's even better. And so we threw this away, but we have an attention. Do not return this product to the store. Turtle Beach can help. Whatever. Now we have your PC mobile, you have a little quick start guide, which is good. Here it shows you can use it with iPad, you can use it with an iPhone, tablet, and it actually even has a PSP on there, which it has a 3.5 jack, so it's kind of obvious, but it's nice that they recognize some older hardware. You have a Turtle Beach sticker, if anybody's interested in that. If you're interested in the sticker, you get a free sticker with it. And then you do have the warranty. So if you want to register this for warranty, you can, I guess. So it's good. And all the cable length for everything is pretty good. I think with the RCA though, it might, maybe it looks a little short, but it for the USB, it's very good. And they actually give you quite a solid quick start guide. And you have your package contents, you have your removable boom mic. We have all the RCA, the cables and the splitters. We have, here you have your controls here, your mute button, mute and unmute, your little volume rocker there. And here, you know, it's showing, you know, just some simple ways to connect it, which is good. Just in case you don't know how to connect it, well, I mean, which you should, it's very simple. But in case you don't, I mean, this, it shows you how, I mean, even for the PS3 also. You know, I mean, this is really, it's really compatible with anything. And that's why I keep kind of saying that, you know, for the price that we got, the price for this headset, it's a really solid headset. And it actually also looks like here, they're showing a PS4 here. I don't know if we can see that. But they're showing a PS4 here, and if you actually look at it, this part right here is actually a USB going in, the USB connector going into PS4's USB, so you may even be able to use this through USB on PS4 and on Xbox One, which is quite interesting, because every time I've tried to use a USB headset, I've never had success with them on console. But that's my unboxings, and it's unboxing, I wouldn't say it's a review, it's a vague overview of what this headset is. And again, I mean, for like $40, that's without discounts and coupons. I mean, you can't really beat that, so... You know, I'll come back with a review, but I would say so far, just from this unboxing and what they've given you and the compatibility of this headset and what you can use it for and build quality, the Turtle Beach Earforce Recon 60P looks like a pretty solid headset, I'm not gonna lie. So let me know what you guys think. If any of you have this headset, let me know how you feel about it. And I hope that this helped you guys in making an informed decision, and I'm gonna recommend it. Yeah. So I hope you guys liked it.